My research discusses games from ancient history all the way up to the present and how they've been used as modeling technologies, particularly in the history of computing. I found in my most recent research that Charles Babbage and Ada Lovelace, two figures who were responsible for the creation of the modern computer, they were both obsessed with games. We know from Charles Babbage's memoirs that he was a huge fan of chess at Cambridge. Ada Lovelace, one of the first letters she ever writes to Charles Babbage, she says, "Hey, could we solve the game of solitaire using mathematics?" And this found its way into her study of algorithms before she became what we call the world's first programmer. This all adds up to a systematic study of games that lasted decades of their career and influenced every aspect of their designs for a computer. One of the big ways that chess changed in the 1800s was to think of it as one giant mechanism with a bunch of different interchangeable parts. And this mechanism could anticipate things, and it had memory, just like chess players did. Just like the Mechanical Turk, which was a famous hoax designed to fool people into thinking that there was some artificial intelligence, Charles Babbage thought maybe you could anticipate future chess moves with a computer and figure out how to solve the game of chess. But if you wanted to do that, the computer would have to think several steps ahead. If you move your rook here, for instance, the opponent can calculate a few moves in advance and realize that they have a forced win on their hands if they capture that rook. So you think through all the possible moves and you realize, oh, now you are forced to recapture this rook. And once you do that, you are forced to take my bishop. And once that happens, you are forced to allow your pawns to be captured by my pawns, and then I'm going to win the game. And if a computer can think through all those if-then steps, that allows it to have what we would consider some sort of intelligent process. Charles Babbage was already thinking about AI back in the 19th century. This found its way into every aspect of his designs for the analytical engine, which was the earliest design for a modern computer. Just this month, researchers who solved the game of Go with AlphaGo won a Nobel Prize in chemistry for AlphaFold. They used a lot of algorithms that they developed in the study of games to solve the real world problems that they were looking at. Games continue to be influential in every aspect of artificial intelligence, and they change how we understand the history of computers. It's really important that we recognize that computers were not just invented by one solitary genius, but were influenced by millennia of different little discoveries and little techniques that people developed using games, these things that are just sitting around us at all times.